This is in real time, okay? Just gonna show you.
Just going. Get a little bit of air blowing. And it's raining out, by the way. There you go, ready to forge.
Well, that's how fast you can get it going if you use my method, the Brazel method.
So what I plan on showing you is a couple little short demos, very short. This is gonna be real quick, so pay attention. I'm not gonna fuck around. A bunch of my pot racks have what I call fishtail or fan tails, made out of flat bar. I use a lot of flat bar. This is a 1 by 3/16 flat bar. And basically it's just a flared end with sort of flutes in it. And you can use a handheld tool, hit the tool, strike the tool. But I just like to use a hammer. So I have a hammer that I've made just for that job. This started out as a 2.5 pound maul. Basically I cut it off and I forged it into the shape I wanted, and I put a very narrow, I don't know what you would call it, but you know what I'm talking about, the shape here. And it's pretty skinny. It's probably only about 1/4 inch, and it's rounded so that it doesn't bite in too bad. And this hammer's fully dressed for forging, nice and round. And this is how it goes. So into the fire. I start in the middle and I hit it probably 2 inches up on a 1-inch bar. And then you progressively work more and more just at the front. And that's it. That's really all there is to it. It's a pretty simple feature on wrought iron things, and it's pretty simple to do. And it looks great. It looks like a nicely forged item to add to your collection of stuff. What I'm going to show you now is how you can make another feature, a wrought iron feature, another wrought iron piece, from this. This would be your starting point. Again, I can't think of the proper term, but some people call it like a fiddlehead, or I'm sure there's some other term for it. I really could care less what the term is. It is what it is. It's beautiful. And it's just like a small scroll made out of a flared bar like this. So we're gonna put that back in the fire. Put a fairly long heat, like a 4-inch heat. You don't want it really, really hot, because you don't want to destroy those flutes. So that's actually a little too hot. I'm gonna let that cool just a little. You're gonna find the nice round part of your anvil here. Just get that started. You're gonna create that to begin with. You gotta have that very beginning. And and you start rolling it around. You see how the very beginning's got a little bit of extra bend in it? Just gonna refine that like that. So it's gonna look like that. I'm gonna come back. Square it up with the anvil, using the side of the anvil. That's basically it. You can do it in varying degrees of tightness. You can actually scroll it around a couple times if you like, but if you do that, you need to put these flares further back down the bar, because every time you wrap it around, you're starting to lose it. It's going to hide inside, right? So if you don't want to lose that feature, then just don't wrap it as much. That's a fiddlehead. That's what I call it, because it looks like the end of a fiddle.